hot cuppa and relax. It's Evening Karak with Aisha Al-Mazmi and Mikhail Atia
on Pulse 95.
Just a little heads up, if I start talking very slowly throughout these 2 hours,
what did you eat?
I had a lot of shawarma today. Like,
I thought you learned your lesson from day one. You said you're not going to overeat because you had
butter chicken. I really tried. But then, you know, you're fasting all day. There's this thing when iftar comes along, your appetite is at peak level. It's like it wants to eat. And
I'm the opposite, actually.
I'm just like, I had like a whole like plate of shawarma with garlic dip and some chicken wings. And now I kind of regret it because...
You think?
Yeah, even drinking some water, it's hurting a little, but
we'll
get through it.
Well, obviously, the water is going to just weigh you down.
If I end up puking, you'll know why.
I think I should be ready with the next button just in case something happens.
Just in case, yeah.
I mean, if anybody's watching us on YouTube, they probably will see things and...
I'll probably have to put a plastic bag on this microphone.
Do you like want to maybe take a walk around here or something?
I'm good. Should I make the
breaks longer perhaps?
If anything, sitting is probably going to solve the problem, hopefully.
It's not. It's just the opposite. You need to move around.
Okay, I'll move around after the break. Don't worry.
Should I put a longer song? Because our song is quite short, actually.
No. We'll carry through. Don't worry.
You'll carry through. Is that a promise?
I promise.
It's true. You're trying to try your best because it's very important. Again, we do not want to traumatize anybody who's watching us on YouTube. And if anybody's listening to us right now through the radio or through the application, the Sharjah Broadcasting Authority application, or on Pulse 95 radio either, we don't want to traumatize them with some very graphic sounds either, Mikhail.
We'll keep that for the improv storytelling.
Oh, yeah, we do have it today. Today is Mikhail's turn.
Yes.
Hopefully.
We're
going to
be doing some improvisation. We tell a premise. And we complete the story, taken turn by turn. Sometimes it's going to have an ending, but sometimes we realize there could be no ending at all.
It's more like me realizing that Mikhail needs to take a walk to refresh his brain and come back. And, you know, it's all fun and games right here on the Evening Karak. We also have, of course, our riddle. Guys, it's still going on. It is only... it's the 8th day of Ramadan, but it is the 7th riddle right here on Pulse 95, which means you could be the lucky winners of 500 dirhams from the
Sharjah Chamber of Commerce and Industry.
I was going to say again. I ruined it.
It's okay. It's Wednesday, my dudes.
I forgot that. Hold on.
It is Wednesday, my dudes.
I forgot it was Wednesday, to be honest. But then, you know, it makes you happier and excited because tomorrow is Thursday and it's going to be the weekend again. And it's going to be the beginning of the second week of Ramadan. All fun and games right here. Well, throughout the week and throughout the entirety of Ramadan right here on Pulse 95. We're also going to be talking about some Marvel news. What is Evening Karak / Afternoon Karak? Well, that's some Marvel news, and this is big. I've got Olivia Colman and the amazing Daenerys Targaryen, also known as the amazing Emilia Clarke. They both might be joining Secret Invasion that we don't know much about, but we kind of have an idea about it. We're going to be talking about that and so much more right here on the Evening Karak.
Make a hot cuppa and relax. It's Evening Karak with Aisha Al-Mazmi and Mikhail Atia
on Pulse 95.
My favorite thing ever about this announcement is that everybody was losing their minds that Marvel is going to have two queens being part of the MCU, and those are Olivia Colman and Emilia Clarke. Now, this isn't 100% confirmed, but it's not exactly a rumor because it was an exclusive report from Variety. Apparently, they're going to be joining Marvel's upcoming Secret Invasion, and Secret Invasion is quite secretive, to say the least.
Yeah.
It was during, you remember when we had the whole display of what is going to be coming up from Marvel Studios on Disney Plus and beyond? And it was just announced at the very end, and we have no idea what's it going to be besides the fact that it's going to center around the Skrulls that have apparently, secretly invading Earth for the longest time ever, And now they've appeared. They've reappeared.
Yeah, it's a really weird story that only, if I ever want to get reference, I have to look into the comics. There's actually in one of the stories from the Secret Invasion, it was revealed, it was like a big twist, that the Civil War was instigated by the Skrulls because they disguise themselves as the Avengers. I'm not sure if they're going to do stuff like that, but when you say Secret Invasion, it means that maybe the Skrulls were part of some sort of, you know, chain of events of previous MCU films. And we did get a little bit of a tease on, I think it was WandaVision episode 9.
Yeah, the final episode at the very, at this, during one of the two credit scenes.
Monica Rambeau, aka Photon, she gets an encounter. She meets a Skrull, and it's like, we're gonna need you. And I'm like, oh, okay.
Yeah, when they're like, oh, an old friend wants to speak to you. And you're like, ooh. Who's that old friend?
Captain Marvel?
And, or is it the Skrulls?
Probably the Skrulls. We know that Samuel L. Jackson is definitely going to be part of this Secret Invasion as well.
Yes. I mean, they are his besties, aren't they? All the way back from Captain Marvel. Also, Ben Mendelsohn, Kingsley Benadire, were also announced as part of the cast a good while back. But I believe Olivia's and Amelia's additions are the biggest names so far. And
I mean, these are award-winning actors.
Exactly.
So.
And I cannot wait to find out what exactly or where exactly are they going to fall in. I think I was reading about various theories and whatnot. I think one of them might actually play a queen as well.
Okay. I guess the if it is Amelia Clark, you know, I guess nothing falls too short from the tree in a way.
Like, in a way.
She continues to play queen in every big role out there. So, yeah, why not?
And I'm just trying to figure out who else can appear from the MCU. Obviously, Photon, most likely, since it was kind of hinted back in WandaVision. And since, I believe, Secret Invasion happens after Doctor Strange, and not before it, am I correct?
If we are taking from exactly the events of WandaVision, that means it's exactly right after the blip and maybe right before Dr. Vision. Maybe. Meanwhile, while the multiverse thing happens, you got the Secret Invasion taking place as well. So
The Secret Invasion has been going on for years, apparently.
Okay.
So that's the secret, because they've just been there for the longest time ever.
So we're gonna be doing a lot of flashbacks until we get to...
I don't think so, honestly. That's going to be too messy again. They're going to focus on them appearing, because like we said, when we got that little hint that Monica Rambeau was being asked to meet up with a friend, again, I feel like that's the Skrulls calling her. And it's very interesting because from what we understood, at some point, even back in Marvel Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., we kind of figured out that the Skrulls were kind of, you know, were there already. Because, again, this might be a bit of a spoiler for the series.
But it could also be retcon, so...
The thing is, back in the series, and what happened is that... Do you remember Phil Coulson, who died all the way back in the Avengers,
yes,
and then he reappears?
Mm-hmm.
So that is exactly how they bring him back. They actually used the Skrull's blood to bring him back to life. So he has alien blood within him. And basically, it was a shock to him because he's like, what do you mean those creatures have always been here? Why are they here in the first place? And what are they doing? So this could be a way of taking that storyline, also continuing it here. We don't know. We always question the legitimacy of Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., if it's actually real or within the MCU canon, or is it just
existing? Until Kevin Feige says otherwise.
Exactly. We have no idea. It's just a gray area. Nobody ever speaks about it anymore. And yeah, we don't know. But then basically back in Captain Marvel, we kind of find out that they're actually friendly and they're not bad.
Yeah.
But in Secret Invasion, they make it seem as if, like, no, they're not all friendly. Maybe some of them are problematic, or maybe all of them are problematic. That's why I'm a bit confused about where this goes. And
it's gonna
where
be basically Among Us, the Marvel story.
Oh my god.
Who's sus?
The Skrulls, apparently.
Yeah.
And again, since they didn't exactly tell us when Secret Invasion will happen, I'm guessing it's gonna be around 2023, because according to what we have from MCU Phase 4, It ends, She-Hulk, Moon Knight, and Doctor Strange and Thor all come out in 2022.
What about Captain Marvel 2? Maybe does it come after or before?
Because
I know it might.
We're not too sure, because that hasn't been given a solid date either.
Okay.
And again, this is only the upcoming Phase 4. They might actually be part of Phase 5, and it just tells you that Marvel Studios is just running right now. They're picking up the pace, and we can't be any more happier than this. Coming up next, you guys might be the happy lucky winners of 500 dirhams. Just tune in a couple of minutes, because we're going to be revealing the riddle of the day. So stay tuned for that.
Riddle me this.
You know that Ramadan is the month of giving, and if you're tuning in to the Evening Karak, we are going to be giving 500 dirham cash on the daily for you guys. All you got to do is answer this simple riddle. Text us 4215 into Salant or Do. Let's play the riddle, listen well, and text us.
Does anybody else feel like a fried egg?
But you can call me
the Riddler.
Riddle me this.
You ride on a horse, followed by a car. On your right flies an airplane. Where are you? Let me repeat that. You ride on a horse, followed by a car. On your right flies an airplane. Where are you?
The awesome Sharjah Ramadan Festival is back. Solve the riddle and win 500 dirhams cash daily. It's also your chance to win wow prizes from participating outlets. Organized by Sharjah Chamber of Commerce and Industry.
Okay, that is super, super tricky. This is very hard. I have to imagine I'm riding a horse.
Yes.
Followed by a car. On my right, specifically on my right, I am seeing an airplane. Where am I?
In my dreams, I guess.
In your dreams, because that's the only surreal situation I can imagine myself in. Okay, weirdly enough, I'm thinking I'm on a horse, right? Followed by a car.
Yeah.
So I am a horse in a field, in a farming field.
Okay.
Behind me is followed by a car, which is could possibly be
Here we go.
Tractor. So I am a farmer riding a horse carried by a tractor behind me. I look out in the distance, I see an airplane. I am in a farm. I don't know how I thought of this. I just did. Listen, you say dreams, I say farm. I'm trying here.
You're really
challenging. This is a very tough riddle.
You're really challenging the ocean answer.
Listen, I'm keeping that for when it needs to be contextually appropriate for the riddle, but it doesn't seem it's going to be the case.
So it's not the ocean this time?
No.
Definitely not the ocean.
No, because the horse thing, you're riding a horse, there's a car behind you, or
yeah.
A car follows you, and then you're looking to your right, you see a plane. You know, someone said to me earlier today that it could be like a board game.
Oh, like Monopoly.
Monopoly, yeah. But then there isn't a horse piece in Monopoly.
Maybe in some sort of special edition, perhaps.
But are we doing like Monopoly special edition as an answer?
Oh God, no, that's going to be too specific. But again, guys, as usual, as we tell you every single day, we don't know the answer, as you can see. We promise you we're not making this up on the go. We're genuinely as confused as you are.
Mm-hmm.
But at least you guys have the ability to actually Google the question.
We're not allowed. We signed contracts, NDAs.
All of that.
There's lawyers involved where we got the cameras. There's actual footage.
Yeah, like our bosses are actually watching us right now to make sure that we're not touching our phones and Googling the answer, because we're not allowed to. So because of that, we're giving you guys the chance to Google it on our behalf and answer, because you might be one of the lucky winners this week and throughout the month of Ramadan, the lucky winners of 500 dirhams, courtesy of the Sharjah Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Thank you, Mikhail. And I'm trying to think, what can I get with 500 dirhams, Mikhail?
What can I get for 500 dirhams? No shawarma.
No
not any more shawarma.
I'll tell you what you can get.
What?
Green tea, like lots of green tea.
Like matcha.
No, green tea.
Green tea, okay. So I can clean out my stomach.
Yes,
or
give it a break.
I can get, what's it called, aloe vera oil? Something like that?
No, that's for burns.
Oh, no. What's the other one?
Why would you drink aloe vera?
There's this other type of detoxing oil.
Yeah.
To clean out your stomach. No. I don't know what it is. Like, I forgot what it is. But no, no shawarma. For 500 dirhams, I do feel like dessert, so I'd probably go to Baskin Robbins.
No, Mikhail. No, you literally said you feel bloated and you cannot move and you feel like
puking. There's always room for dessert, you know what I'm saying? So I go to Baskin Robbins. You know how they have that 31 flavor?
Yeah.
I get all 31 different flavors.
Valid. It's very valid, but not today. I don't think that's a good idea. But for today, what can you get for 500 dirhams?
What can I get for 500 dirhams? I could probably do a couple of trips. I can do some, I can go and do some, what do you call it? Jet skiing. For the
jet
weekend.
Jet skiing, true. It is
jet skiing sessions, some of those, what do you call it, paragliding jet ski sessions as well. Just go out into the ocean. Ocean. Just had to put it in there.
You and the ocean. What is up with you and the ocean?
What about you, Aisha?
Also, I want to tell you that we do not live by the ocean. It's the sea.
Okay.
It's the Arabian Gulf, which is a sea.
Thank you for that.
But if I need to, Mikhail, I need to teach you geography. Science.
It's been a while since I've been in college or high school, you know?
Same here.
You start losing those little
details. I mean, I graduated way before you, Mikhail.
I see. Okay.
And yet, it's very important, integral. I believe I said this last week that you and Umnia Saleh from Future Talk, each of you sit down, go on Netflix and look up any animal documentary.
Or Vox Explained videos.
Vox Explained videos for you to basically
refresh my memory
on a lot of things.
Okay.
Especially the geography of the surrounding area. Because again, we live next to a sea and not the ocean. But guys, let's circle back to the riddle. Text us 4215 Ittisalat or do and tell us what you're going to spend those 500, how you're going to spend those 500 dirhams. And of course, what is the correct answer? And also tell us your name so we can give you a shout out later on. And yeah, you might be one of the lucky winners. And we are all wishing you
the best of luck, because we don't
know. Best of luck.
Honestly.
All the luck.
The guess is as good as yours at this point.
Again, Google is your friend. It's not our friend, but it is definitely your friend. We're going to be taking a very short break. We're going to move on to an exciting story. I was excited about it until I read the fine lines in between. I was like, you know what? I'm upset now. And that is the amazing, one of my favorite actresses, Dakota Johnson, is going to be starring in Jane Austen's Persuasion. But why am I upset about it? You're going to be finding out very soon after this very, very short break.
Once upon a time, in Sharjah, impromptu storytelling with Evening Karak.
All right, let's get into our latest edition here on the Evening Karak. A personal favorite as well, the improv storytelling, in which we take a premise, any sort of like just a sentence, and try to complete the story. Me and Aisha are going to take turns as we take the direction of the story and the characters to God knows what's going to happen.
God knows where it could go.
So yeah, let's start off with the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
Let's cue,
I think, drama music.
Let's cue some drama music. You're
drama
right. Let's
music.
Do it. Okay, so the story prompt for this is our main character, and his name is...
It's not me.
We're going... let's go for a third person. Like, let's...
Why?
I think we should change it up a bit.
I like it more when it's us.
I feel like
it's
we should give a separate character. Because I feel the character we can invent the character as we go. You know, if it's just us, I feel like we're limited to ourselves. You know what I mean?
But there's no limit to us.
Let's try it this time. I just want to try it.
Fine, can it be a girl, please?
Okay, our main character, what's her name? Let's see. Sarah.
Okay, Sarah.
Okay, our main character, Sarah, she's coming back from work, and she parks her car, and she notices there's another car right beside her, abandoned. The keys are still inside, and the doors are open. What's that about? Aisha, take it from here.
So Sarah looks into, she tries to look, peek through the windows. Obviously, she finds the keys are still inside. So she's very suspicious. What is going on here? But she looks at the back seat, and she finds a little child sleeping.
Oh, no.
Off to you, Mikhail.
Okay, so immediately Sarah is shocked. She's wondering, what's going on here? Why was this car here? Could this be the neighbor? She goes, knocks on the neighbor's door, And they tell her, it's like, no, this is not our car. Something wrong. And Sarah immediately just, you know, pulls back. She's like, no, I don't want to get people involved because then they might accuse me of kidnapping this child.
But it's not your car. It's not her car. How could she kidnap
them? That's the thing. She wants to deal with it on her own. So she runs back. She notices the kid is still sleeping, right?
Mm-hmm.
So she gets in the car and she opens the glove compartment and something comes out. Your turn.
I mean, wouldn't you call the police first and say, hey, there's a child here?
Well,
Mikhail, that's priorities are wrong. First of all, she calls the police.
this is what makes the story interesting. This is like when you watch a movie and you ask yourself, why isn't the character doing that? Why isn't he calling the police? No, the character's going for that glove compartment.
No, she calls the police. This makes no sense. Why would she go for the glove compartment when there's a human being sleeping behind and it's a tiny person? So it's a small child who either could be kidnapped, lost, and whatever.
Okay.
So she calls the police first.
So she calls the police.
And tells the police that, hey, I found a car and there's a child here. And they're like, check the child. Are they okay? Yeah, the child is fine. They're breathing. Their pulse is normal. They're just sleeping in the back of the car. And you're like, okay. So she's like, we're going to send in somebody right now to come and check it out. Then she goes to the glove compartment to look for any sort of ID. Mikhail, see, this is... we need to make it believable, okay?
Okay.
Sarah is not a crazy person. She's not a murderer, or is she? We don't know yet. But anyway, back to the story. Opens a glove compartment, and that's when she finds just a ton of walnuts.
Walnuts?
Just lots of walnuts.
Okay.
They just keep on falling out one after the other. There's so many of them.
A bunch of walnuts. Okay.
It's a bunch of walnuts.
Boy, you really... This is
what you... This is what you get.
Okay.
For not making me the main character of the story.
Sarah notices all these walnuts falling out of the car. It's almost seeping from the doors. And she's freaking out. She's trying to put them all back. And from the noise, the child wakes up. And she says, where's mommy? Sarah's like, I don't know. I just found you here. I called the police. She's like, wait, you called the police? It's like, yes. She's like, we gotta go. It's like, what? Turn the car. We gotta go.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And now we got excited.
Now we get excited. I think we should move towards action.
Yes.
How about that?
Okay.
She freaks out, obviously. Should she be listening to a child? Not really.
Yeah.
But, adrenaline
hits. There's walnuts, there's a kid.
Adrenaline hits, and she freaks out, right? And
yeah.
And she's like, but the police, she's like, no, you need to go right now. And she's like, what else am I going to do?
Mm-hmm.
And just as she was about to back out the car, the police arrive.
Okay.
Police arrive, and they're like, uh-oh, what is going on? What are we going to do now? The child is panicking.
Mm-hmm.
And when you look at the child, they kind of look very strange. They kind of, you'd say that...
They don't look like a kid.
They don't feel... No, they look like a kid.
They look more mature than a normal kid.
They obviously the body of a kid, everything. But the mannerisms are not that of a kid. So what is going on here?
Okay. Do you think we should end it here and wait for part two? Or you want me to continue in some way?
You know what? Let's take a break. Let's give it a bit of a cliffhanger.
Yeah.
A suspense.
What
kind
is Sarah going to do? The police are there.
The
kid is telling her, just press gas on the pedal. What is Sarah going to do?
Stay tuned to find out. Coming right up next, right after this short break, right here on the Evening Cuttack.
Once upon a time, in Sharjah, impromptu storytelling with Evening Karak.
So before we get back to the story, I feel like we need to set the mood. I don't think it should be action right now. It should be suspense.
Suspense.
Why? Because, the story started when Sarah came back home, and in the parking lot, she finds a car that is still has a key inside, and she finds a small child inside. She asks the neighbors. The neighbors have no idea who it is. She calls the police because she finds a little child inside the back seat, and she freaks out. And when she opens the glove compartment, just a ton of walnuts just come out of the glove compartment, which is going to be super important to the story, and I'll tell you why later on. And right around, you know, while she's imploring, looking through the car, the child wakes up. She tells the child that, you know, I called the police because nobody's here. And she's like, uh-oh, you need to drive right now, very fast. And as she was about to do that, because of the suspense and the, you know, the adrenaline and whatnot, because should you be listening to a random child? Not really. But again, adrenaline hits and you don't know what you're supposed to do. So you listen to a child, a random child you found on the back seat. But the police arrives, and she's looking at the child is looking at her. And that's what also she notices. The child kind of is weird in the sense that even though they look like a child, they kind of have some weird mannerisms.
That make him look a bit more mature than
that. Mature, or not even mature, just outright weird.
Like a kid would not act this way.
Let's say they're like a mechanic kid. Very mechanic and weird.
Robotic.
Very robotic. And it's like, what is going on? What is this child? What is going on? Why are they looking for their mom? What is happening here? Mikhail, it's your turn. The police have arrived.
Okay.
What are you going to do?
She's in the car. The walnuts are still seeping out of the door.
Not that many walnuts. Khalas, khalas.
I just thought like
there's a lot. No, they had a lot of walnuts. That is true. Walnuts and whatnot. But yeah, and it all seeped around on the passenger seat. Yeah,
yeah,
but
khalas. She closed the door.
Yeah, she closed the door.
The police are approaching. The child is now grabbing Sarah's arm. She's like, don't speak with them. Just get the car running. Let's get out of here. And it's like, this is crazy. Why would you want me to do this? And the kid starts crying. She's pleading. She says, they're gonna if they catch me, that's it. Like, I'm not gonna be able to find mommy anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and as she looks out, the police officer is slowly approaching her. And, you know, it's like, ma'am, weren't you the one to report us? Come speak with us. And in that moment, she doesn't know if she can trust the child, but the she sympathizes.
Who can she trust?
The mm-hmm. police, they kind of look sus outside, and the kid is crying, like the poor kid.
And
so she succumbs to the child's demands. She closes the door, the police backs up, is like, whoa, what's going on here? She turns on the car, she goes on reverse, and the police pulling out their gun, they're like, you know, get out of the car right now, ma'am. They're thinking she's the child kidnapper, right?
Child kidnapper, yes.
Yeah, she opens the window. She's like, I'm sorry, officer, but I gotta go. And she just puts gas on the metal. She's driving down the road. Police sirens start activating.
Mikhail, you took up my part. You said the entire story. Khalas.
Really?
It's my turn.
Okay.
It's my turn.
I turn on the gas pedal.
My turn.
It's a two-people story. I don't know
story.
Where to end. Okay.
So throw it at me.
Okay. I'm throwing that at you. Backs up from the driveway.
She doesn't actually back up because she had it on drive. So she drives right into the the car, the house instead, obviously.
Okay.
So she crashes into the car, into the front porch, and obviously she's kind of, you know, hits her head a bit, and the policeman is running. There are two of them. They run to the car. And the child is kind of glaring at her. It's like, really? Really? I'm asking for help, and this is what you do to me?
Yeah.
And the child is showing attitude, and you're like, what is up with this?
You're putting me in this situation.
Like, what is up with this kid? And then it's like, fine, I need to deal with it myself.
Yeah.
And that's when the police arrive, and remember the walnuts, right? You might be wondering, why are there lots of walnuts? Do you want to know why, Mikhail?
Oh, dear,
you want to know why?
I want to know. Tell me.
You want to know why? Because actually, that wasn't a human. That was a bunch of squirrels in a human suit.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is quite the twist. I was thinking like the walnuts had diamonds. The kid is a part of a crime syndicate.
No,
you
it's
know.
Just a bunch of squirrels in a human suit. They're trying to.
I'm just gonna put my headphone down. And just say goodbye. Goodbye, everybody. The end for improv storytelling.
Well, it is the end because we have to kind of wrap up, but it's okay, Mikhail. It was a good story, wasn't it? I mean, It is what it is. And with that, we end our improv story. I mean, guys, come on. It was a good one. It was a good ending.
You did surprise me, I'll say that much.
It was a good ending. I mean, had to wrap it up. And honestly, I had the idea since the walnut thing, but you kept on ruining it, Mikhail. I was trying to get to that part. And you kept really, and then they run, and it's a chase. And I'm like, calm down. Just calm down, Shweya. We need to just, you know, rein it back in a bit. But yeah, it's a bunch of squirrels. Guys, tell us, isn't this our best story yet? It could be. I think it's our second best, maybe.
I weirdly hate it, but love it at the same time.
It's a good one. It's a good one. Anyway, we're going to be taking a short break, and then we'll be back for another hour of the Evening Karak. So stay tuned for that and so much other types of fun right here on Pulse 95.
Make a hot cuppa and relax. It's Evening Karak with Aisha Almazmi and Mikhail Atiyah
on Pulse 95.
The fun continues right here on the Evening Karak as we have so much more to talk about, starting with a celebration. I was actually just sitting there for a while and trying to figure out, have we celebrated this thing or have we not? I think we did, but I don't think we did at the same time.
We're almost up to 600 episodes.
Yeah.
For just the Afternoon Karak, Evening Karak show. So after a while, yeah, you start looking back. It's like, did we celebrate this or not? Doesn't matter. It needs to be celebrated.
Oh, it needs to be celebrated. Actually, today we had several celebrations, but I think we need to focus on this one, especially during Ramadan. It's very important, integral to a lot of meals, especially suhoor, hint, hint. I feel a lot of people have suggested that they eat that before going to bed. So we're going to be talking about that, but also going to be talking about Dave Bautista's interview, because he is going to be starring in the upcoming Zack Snyder movie. And apparently he's made a lot of interesting commentary, starting with the fact that he actually wanted to play Bane, which is very interesting. And apparently he doesn't want a Drax TV show on Disney Plus.
I love when celebrities just straight up rant on any public interview, because you really get to see how they really are.
Especially Dave. He's notorious for doing that very, very often. We're also going to be talking about Square Enix, that have already announced officially that they're going to be part of E3. So what can they actually showcase during that very important weekend, honestly?
Also, another movie by Adam Sandler is going to be in the works. I don't know how many Adam Sandler movies there are already, but boy, this guy is making bank with Netflix. So
here's a question, though. Is this the movie he said?
Okay.
Do you remember the movie he said?
I remember he said that he would jeopardize one film if...
If Uncut Gems was not nominated and he doesn't win anything for doing the Oscars.
Yes. Could this be the promise?
We don't know, because even though it seems a very serious movie, but it feels very un-Adam Sandler, to say the least. The premise of it is very interesting, and Carey Mulligan is actually going to be part of it, and it's going to be part of our discussions within the next hour. And also, a very important part of the hour is the riddle.
Yes, don't forget the riddle, guys. Be sure to listen throughout the hour. Text us 4215 into Salat or do. Give us a reason as to what you'd be spending that 500 dirhams with. And if it's good as the answer, we might just pick it. So, hey, we want to make somebody's night lucky. So be sure to stay locked and stay tuned to the Evening Karak.
What's the date?
What's the date?
What's the date?
What are we celebrating today?
April 21st. We just want to give a happy birthday wish to Omar Al-Duri, one of our presenter for Halftime Show. Really nice to see him come in today. Had a nice smile. We all hugged him, and I got him a little nice little present. And, just 21st of April has a very sort of bonding memory to all of us here at Pulse 95. If only we can celebrate with a cake, but, you know, we're all fasting, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. But now that it's already around 9 o'clock, we're past iftar, there is one thing that you can celebrate with, and that is a lovely banana.
Yes, because today we're celebrating Banana Day. It is also Tea Day, by the way.
Okay.
Which is really cool, but I remember celebrating it at some point. So I'm like, let's move on to the trusty banana. I I think this is a good day to celebrate because I have a lot of random banana facts. Are you ready for this?
Okay, go ahead.
That is actually my specialty, and that is the history of the banana. Don't ask why, but
Jane Austen connoisseur, banana historian. What else do you got, Aisha?
Well, fun fact. Do you know that all bananas are clones of each other?
Okay. I heard something about like how bananas have somewhat of a DNA blueprint similar to humans.
No, they're actually, it's okay. So usually when you have an offspring of a sort of a plant similar to humans, you know, it's a combination of two parents. You take their half the DNA here, half the DNA there, and they have a very different, unique offspring, and then so on and so forth. Same thing with plants and fruits and vegetables. They're all exactly the same thing. Half here, half here, you give an offspring.
Okay.
Offspring with somebody else, and then half gives you another unique set of DNA. But no, it's the same banana again and again and again and again and again. And that's exactly every single banana you've been eating.
Wow.
For all your lifetime. And I say our lifetime because previously there was a completely different banana that was also the exact same banana. That is called there's a Cavendish banana and also the Gros Michel. The thing that happened to the Gros Michel, if I'm going to pronounce it in French, is that because it was a clone of each other, it got affected by a type of disease, basically, a banana disease.
Oh, dear.
And because they're clones of each other,
yeah,
it's not like they kind of developed the ability to become stronger or different from each other.
They don't evolve. They just are a copy of another.
Exact copy of another. So it was basically wiping them out one after the other. So they had to be like, uh-oh, we need to make a new type of banana. And that's exactly what they did. And they didn't learn their lesson. And they made exact copies of that new banana as well. So there are some people who are saying banana cultivists and whatnot that, you know, history might actually repeat itself.
Yeah.
And this type of banana might actually go extinct. But actually, there are still some places in the world that still kind of grow the Gros Michel. And it's actually, I think I've mentioned this before, that it's actually one of my dreams to try it out because it has a very distinctive flavor. And they claim that that banana is what the banana flavoring is. You know, when you eat those candy and you're like, that tastes really weird, I don't like it. Mm. It's because it's the old banana taste.
So, like, there is a truer form of, a truer flavor of banana that we don't ever have the privilege to eat.
I wouldn't say a truer form, it's just a version. Just like how if you go to Southeast Asia and East Asia, there are so many types of bananas that you've never heard of, have never seen. I mean, there are tiny ones, the fingerling bananas, there's the green ones, there's all types of them that we just never, ever heard of.
Yeah.
So it's just another one that's become a commercialized, the standard type of banana that is everywhere in the entire world. So that's it.
That is a mind-blowing fact. Happy Banana Day for everybody. And the best way to celebrate Banana Day is to go out and get yourself a banana. Eat it with anything. Mm-hmm. Banana split, banana bread, banana flavored ice cream, banana flavored banana milkshake. Just banana, 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 Batman, banana. I don't know why I did that.
It's a good day to celebrate, to say the least. I mean, bananas are super cool. And if you know somebody who still has the Gros Michel somewhere here and there, I would love to try it because apparently it's incredibly sweet, which is funny because I think that the Cavendish banana, which is the banana we eat, is incredibly sweet and I cannot eat it. I cannot tolerate it most of the time.
Really?
Unless it's in a milkshake or a smoothie. I mean, have you ever had a banana peanut butter smoothie?
Delicious.
So good. And also, it's a good type of sahur, guys. Why not have some sort of banana fest and make some, like Mikhail said, all the things Mikhail said, and also be some banana bread, maybe incorporate that into it. Who knows? The ideas are endless for you guys to pick. We're going to be taking a break, and coming up next is the Dave Bautista interview. An interesting interview, to say the least. Stay tuned to find out exactly what he was saying, including the weird stuff, right here on The Evening Karak.
Make a hot cuppa and relax. It's Evening Karak with Aisha Al-Mazmi and Mikhail Atiyah
on Pulse 95.
I'm super glad that my cousin is not tuning in right now, because if he heard me say, I am so excited for Final Fantasy 16, he's going to text me right now and say, what happened to Final Fantasy 15, you big liar?
Oh, because you never played it.
I never finished it.
It's one of those. It's one of those people. I know.
Because basically, okay, so all the way back in 2015, I've been like, I will finish this game. I will get back to it. And he'd be like, did you finish it? I'd be like, I will get back to it. And then I'd post a picture of me playing another game. And he's like, well, I'd be like, I'll get back to it. It's been 6 years. It's been 6 years.
Well, I hope he's not tuning in on the radio or on YouTube.
He's in Kuwait, so I'm maybe on YouTube, but I'm hoping he is not. Like, fingers crossed. No, actually, wait, it was 2016, sorry. 2016, 2017. And yes, I am incredibly excited for Final Fantasy 16. It was one of those surprising but not surprising revelations back when we had the state of play, because we kind of knew, or at least I was sitting here when I was watching, like, please, Square Enix, please, anything from Square Enix, anything. So when it came up, I was like, yes, we're getting something really cool. And obviously, I thought it was going to be the continuation of Final Fantasy VII Remake, but no, we got Final Fantasy 16, and we might be getting a glimpse further into it during E3, because Square Enix has officially announced that it's going to be part of the lineup.
That is really great news, and in a way, it's feeding into the theory we had a while back where a good chunk of the game publishers have still not confirmed if they're going to come to E3, and Square Enix was one of them. And now, as we're slowly getting near to the month of June, Square Enix said, yeah, we're stepping in. We got a lineup of games we want to reveal. And hopefully this could be the beginning of a domino effect for other game publishers who are somewhat reluctant to step back into the E3 showcase. Namely, Activision Blizzard still hasn't confirmed.
Actually, that was your theory. Because my theory was that whoever who was quiet the past year is going to do some sort of revelation. And Square Enix was one of them, because they kind of... I believe also there was another state of play not too long ago where they just literally said, yeah, we're working on stuff, but you're not going to get anything yet.
Okay.
So E3 is probably going to be where all these various studios who have been quiet for the past couple, I'd say even year, maybe even 2 years since late 2019, where they've been kind of saving stuff perhaps for some time last year, but due to the pandemic, they had to push it further and be quieter. So I think E3 would be the perfect timing for them to be like, hey, here's what we've been working on.
Yeah.
As for, you know, the ones that have already kind of spoken about stuff or already kind of working on things and have already revealed them, I believe those are going to be quiet for the next couple of months. Maybe at the end of the year, that's when we're going to get some sort of big revelation from them, or even... they're going to keep on being quiet until next year, because like we said, the pandemic had a lot of unprecedented impacts and effects on a lot of industries, the gaming industry being one of them. We saw what happened with Cyberpunk 2077. There were a lot of things happening before the pandemic, and then the pandemic kind of made it worse, and then we got a really bad result. I believe also Nintendo is the same thing, because I think there were some things that were supposed to come out last year, one of them being I believe the Mario 35 years anniversary celebration. Some things were supposed to come out a bit earlier in the year, and I think they did some data mining or something. I'm trying to remember. That was some insider news that people were digging up a couple of months ago. I believe it was around November, December, perhaps even before that, when they realized that, no, this was supposed to come out all the way back in the beginning of the year, but due to the pandemic, it was pushed further.
I see. Well, for now, Square Enix is the only one so far from that list to jump into E3. Besides Final Fantasy 16, we might also get a glimpse of Final Fantasy Remake Part 2. Maybe even the full-fledged gameplay footage of Forspoken. We got sort of like a behind-the-scenes trailer for that game. Just like 5 seconds, and already got us very intrigued. This is from the same developers of Final Fantasy 15. So I'm really glad that Square Enix is stepping in, and I hope other game publishers, game companies also step in before E3 comes around. I think it's going to be happening June 11 till June 13th.
And if you remember during our first Nintendo Direct of the year, the first big one that we've had for the very longest time, an interesting game called Project Triangle Strategy from Square Enix.
The JRPG.
Yes, the tactical game that felt like it was somewhat of a successor to Octopath Travelers was also kind of hinted. We also got a demo of it that was released back then. It might also be, you know, people might learn more about it during that time, especially since we already know the Nintendo Switch, or at least Nintendo as a whole, is also going to be showcasing their games and console, and perhaps the Nintendo Switch Pro during that time.
And one more. I'm just going to throw it out there. Maybe another Tomb Raider game, because I know Square Enix does own the IP for that game, and I think it was earlier this year they celebrated Tomb Raider's, I think, 20 or 25th anniversary.
Several years.
Yeah, and they did promise that they're going to be revealing some really big things for that franchise soon enough.
Very, very soon. Exciting things for all of us that are fans of Square Enix. If you're not, that is okay. You do have some time to explore their plentiful of titles, especially since Nier Replicant is actually coming out this week.
Oh my God,
are you ready for that? Because I know you're playing Resident Evil 7 right now in preparation for Resident Evil 8. I believe it's going to be really, really, really tight right now, especially since we have Nier Replicant. And I'm trying to remember, there's this some game that I've... Oh yeah, Pokemon Snap is coming out very soon.
Okay.
Resident Evil 8.
Resident Evil 8.
So many games coming out, so perhaps we're going to be getting a lot of game reviews coming very, very soon.
Stay tuned for that.
We're going to be taking a break, guys, and coming up next is that movie by Adam Sandler called Spaceman. Very interesting, not very Adam Sandler-esque. Let's talk about that coming right up next right here on The Evening Kadok.
Make a hot cuppa and relax. It's Evening Karak with Aisha Almazmi and Mikhail Atia
on Pulse 95.
Apparently, Carey Mulligan is set to star alongside Adam Sandler in his upcoming Netflix movie, Spaceman. Now, the question is it going to be the movie that he said he's going to tank on purpose? It's as a way of revenge for not getting nominated or winning anything during the Oscars.
Now, I don't
think so.
I think he's gone past the anger.
Really?
Maybe.
But he made a promise. It was a very, you know, very obvious promise. He said it out loud to every single person out there. And it's been 2 years. And we do know that he's working on several movies for Netflix. So there's also the question of, since he made a deal with Netflix, can he actually risk ruining that deal by making a movie that is really bad on purpose? Especially since this is actually a very interesting movie that is based on a book called The Spaceman of Bohemia. It was released in 2017. It's about an astronaut who is embarking on a solo mission to space who bumps into basically an entity or some kind of thing.
Ancient creature.
And that's interesting. And I can see that it's very serious. And it's very Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy-esque kind of movie or book. And I feel that it could go crazy in some ways, but it also feels very serious.
And I think because it's very serious, it's a production that is... I think Adam Sandler wouldn't want to jeopardize. Maybe he has something to prove with this film. And again, these promises he makes... I think they're ones of very, just like an emotional outburst at the time, you know, when you're angry in the moment and you just kind of splurt out, like, if I don't get nominated for the Uncut Gems, then I'm just going to jeopardize a whole film production for that reason. And if you think my movies are bad, just wait and see. I don't want that to be the case, because this is the premise already kind of sold me on it. I want to see something similar to the Hitchhiker, you know.
Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
And there hasn't been a film like that in a while, so I wouldn't.
In forever, honestly.
Yeah, so I wouldn't want him to ruin this film for some angry spurt that happened 2 years back.
Is it angry or is it legitimate? That's a question.
Only thing we can do now is wait until the movie comes out and just refresh the Rotten Tomatoes reviews and see what happens. Yeah.
I don't trust lots of rating systems, especially since I feel like it's very subjective. Yes, there are some really bad movies that are obviously bad, or some that are really good that are obviously good, but I think that it goes back to personal preferences, just like what we found out when we watched Thunder Force.
That yeah, Allah, this film. Don't watch it.
I have to bring it up. Guys, watch it. Don't listen to him.
See how divided we are? Like, you're thinking, okay, if you're listening for the first time, how is it that there's one presenter saying, don't watch it, the other saying, watch it? You know, usually maybe both of them are in agreement, but that's not the case.
We always have been at least somewhat within the same scope when it comes to reviewing anything. We're either, yani, like 1 point difference, yeah. 2 points maximum. This one was like, what, a whooping 6-7 points apart?
I said 2 out of 10. She said 8 out of 10. And I just hope maybe Spaceman isn't like this as well. So we'll just have to wait and see when it comes out on Netflix.
As usual. But you guys know, even though we promise a lot of reviews here, then we kind of forget, which we apologize for. But we need to review this one when it comes out. It's very important.
It's an Adam Sandler film. I can't forget.
Especially since, again, if his promise, is this the movie or is it not the movie? Is he going to surprise us within those, you know, he's going to make several Netflix movies. Some of them, they're really, really, really good. And in between them, this one really, really bad one, it just ruins it completely for all of us.
If it's not this, then the question is, what could be that really bad movie? We'll just have to wait and see.
As usual, because always a waiting game right here on the Evening Cuddle, but you don't need to wait too long because we're going to be revealing the name of the winner of our riddle. Yes, guys, if you haven't heard the riddle, don't worry. We're going to be playing it for one last time. So get your phones ready, get your fingers ready to text us the answer on 4215 Etisalat or do, and also give us the reason, or at least how will you use those 500 dirhams courtesy of the Sharjah Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and what are you going to do with them? We gave you some ideas already. Mikhail wants to buy all 31 flavors of ice cream, as you might have realized that we're always very food-centric. And since it's banana day, I think that if I had the 500 dirhams, I'm going to use them to somehow ship me a whole box of Gros Michel.
Okay.
Gros Michel. I'm trying to, you know, flex a bit of my French from 8th grade. I hope Madame Fanny is listening right now, and she'll be like, that's my girl.
She's listening in spirit.
I hope so. But yeah, that's what I was going to do. I'd buy a whole box of extinct bananas for 500 dirhams. Text us 4215 Etisalat or do with your answer and how you will use those 500 dirhams. So listen and very, very carefully.
Does anybody else feel like a fried egg?
But you can call me
the Riddler.
Riddle me this, riddle me that.
You ride on a horse, followed by a car. On your right flies an airplane. Where are you?
Riddle me this, riddle me that.
We got the vibe, we got the juice, baby. We got that 500 dirham cash that you can win. If you've been listening and texting us, 4215, it's Slugger2, sharing your answers. We're going to be picking a winner in a couple of minutes. We want to ask you one last time, what would you do with 500 dirham cash? Now, you said you wanted to get yourself the premium banana.
Not the premium banana. It's extinct. Okay. Kind of extinct.
Very rare bananas.
Very rare bananas. Because if you guys were listening from earlier, we were celebrating Banana Day. And during that, I was giving you guys the history of the banana. Aisha, why do you know that? Why wouldn't I know about the history mystery of the bananas. Guys, check it out. If you missed out on our conversations, as usual, you can find our conversations uploaded on as a podcast. You can tune into us wherever you listen to podcasts, and that is, well, Apple Podcasts, Anghami, Spotify, SoundCloud. Again, wherever you listen to podcasts, just search up Evening Karak. Also tune into our old podcast on the Afternoon Karak by also searching up Afternoon Karak. And you can always, you know, also see us, see my facial expressions of whether it's confusion or disappointment.
Disappointment,
anger.
You know, silent laughter.
Silent, usually silent treatment,
silent death glares.
Death glares towards Mikhail as he drives me insane in those 2 hours. If you want to see those, you can always check out our YouTube live stream or the video that's going to be uploaded later on within the night. And are you ready for the answer, Mikhail?
One more thing I just want to add. In dedication for Happy Banana Day,
yeah,
I'd actually, with 500 dirhams, I'd buy a banana suit.
That is
get
valid.
Myself one of those rumba shakers and just go
maracas.
Peanut butter, jelly time, peanut butter. You know, that's good old internet meme.
Good old internet meme for all those people who are using the internet all the way back then. And
Let's get to the answer. The answer for the riddle is, before we say the answer, the riddle is, you ride on a horse, followed by a car. On your right flies an airplane. Where are you? Super confusing. But the answer is a merry-go-round.
Or a carousel. And a lot of you actually got it, which is funny because when the riddle was given to us last night, again, the riddle, not the answer, I was so confused. I was like, I give up. This is confusing. Mm-hmm. I cannot think of anything. But then when all of you guys started answering, we were like,
I see what you're doing there.
Maybe. You guys are incredibly smart. So shout out to all of you who got it correctly. And you guys made it very hard for us because even your answers as to what are you guys going to do with the money were also incredibly amazing.
Just as good.
Some of you are very creative. However, we have to pick one winner. And today's winner just happens to be Norin.
Congratulations, Norin.
Norin. Not sure how to pronounce it. We apologize for that. But Norin says, merry-go-round or carousel, she or he, maybe they, will buy a wristwatch with the Qibla finder for their dad back home and saving money for the last 2 months. So congratulations to Norin. You did it.
Very heartfelt answer.
Very amazing answer. So we wanted to be part of it. And yeah, again, if you got the money, if you finally get it, then you do buy the watch, just like you promised. We want you to take a picture. Why not tag us, Pulse95 Radio on Instagram. And we'd love to give you a like and a shout out, maybe.
Definitely. And that is it, guys. But don't worry, if you miss out on a chance to win 500 dirhams, we're still gonna be giving it out every weekday here at the Evening Cutta, because it's a really long month. And we still got a whole lot of money to dish out for all of you lucky winners. Mm-hmm. But guys, we got to wrap things up. We got to bid you farewell and a good night. And see you guys tomorrow. Same time, same vibes, only here on Pulse 95.
If you liked this episode of Afternoon Karak, drop a like and subscribe.
Pulse 95.
Be sure to follow us on Instagram for all our daily updates and top stories.